For those members who may not know me that well, in my previous job, I ran the financial operation of a department at the University of Pennsylvania. In that job, I was responsible for creating and managing my department's budget. At Penn, we follow the principle that the budget is a statement of priorities for the organization and that the budget tells the story of what is important. To that end, watching this budget process, I see a glaring hole in our priorities, mainly in the area of education funding. In the past two budgets, we have seen drastic reductions for public education funding. These cuts have real impacts in our districts. They create hard choices for our school districts, putting immense budgetary pressure on school budgets to the point where class sizes balloon, after-school services disappear, and teachers file for unemployment. House Bill 1437 is no different. House Bill 1437 does not reverse this tide. It only perpetuates it. If a budget is a statement on priorities, this budget certainly doesn't prioritize public education. Education is an investment in our children, in our neighborhoods, in our economy, and in our great state. Starting with early childhood education through higher education, education is an investment. Many of us proudly bring groups of students to the Capitol when they win state championships or excel in academic areas. Yesterday, we applauded a group of students excelling in STEM studies. Last month, I was fortunate to attend an award ceremony for Lower Merion School District students in my district that included the Science Olympiad team that placed first statewide for 16 consecutive years. I'm fortunate to represent wonderful school districts that provide excellent public education and have the support of the local taxpayers. The taxpayers in my district understand that education is an investment, and they move into these areas because of the excellent schools. But this is not the full story. One of my school districts is planning on using furloughs and demotions to make up their budget gap. Other school districts are planning property tax increases. These actions have real impacts on our children. Larger class sizes, fewer after-school programs, loss of instructional programs, and elimination of school counselors. But the taxpayers, and in particular seniors on fixed incomes, suffer when their property taxes are increased. Because in my district, in addition to great schools, we have food banks and community assistance programs. And my staff spends time helping constituents file for LIHEAP assistance and property tax rebate applications. These are real issues for the people in my district who support public education with their local tax dollars. And then, if we look at public education statewide, or even regionally, we also see the lack of investment in areas with greater levels of poverty. My district borders Philadelphia. We benefit by living so close to a great American city that provides jobs, culture, shopping opportunities, and great sports teams. But we also understand the disparities in education between our great school districts and our neighboring Philadelphia school district. Many of my constituents teach in the Philadelphia school districts. And they are dedicated individuals who work hard to provide a good education to their students. But they spend their own money on school supplies for their students, for paper, even for toilet paper, because all of these items are not always provided in the Philadelphia schools. What a difference from the school districts that I represent. What a sad story for the children attending Philadelphia schools, and what a sad story for Pennsylvania, because a great education produces economic gains and ensures the success of our state. Remember, I told you that I view education as an investment and that budgets tell a story. The priorities of this budget are unfortunately clear with the cuts per student to almost every school district in the Commonwealth when we compare it to the 2010-11 budget. I respectfully urge a no vote